chess. Don't worry if I write rhymes, I write chess. Don't worry if I write rhymes, I write chess.
First of all, each of you has a big sister. She's the one who bosses you around and you have to do exactly what she tells you.
And remember the part about talking back and smiling. No talking unless your big sister asks you something, and no smiling, no matter how badly you want to.
Shoot.
Millicent! Millicent, wait up!
Oh, hi!
Hi, I was so happy when they voted you in.
Yeah, me too, but I'm kind of sorry Tracy didn't get in as well.
Oh yeah, Tracy, she's a nice girl, but she had 3 black balls against her.
What are black balls?
Well, once a year the sorority has a meeting where we discuss all the girls that are suggested for membership, and 3 black balls get you eliminated, so...
Can I ask why she got 3 black balls?
Well, she's just a little bit too different, like the high socks and stuff, she's just a little weird.
Nothing will change between us, we'll go around like we always have, and next year you'll surely get in.
But you'll change whether you think you will or not. Nothing ever stays the same.
Yeah, I guess you're right about Tracy.
Yeah, but anyways, I wanted to warn you about Beth. You drew her as your big sister, and she's kind of the toughest. But if you do good with her, then you're sure to get in.
Awesome, thanks for the heads up. I'm gonna do my best.
Love ya! Bye, XOXO! Be me and me!
Bye!
Bye!
Get up, Gopher.
Are you deaf? I said get up! Get into the house. There's a bed up there to be made and a room to be cleaned. Go!
Wipe that smile off your face. No talking either.
Bev, what's up?
Hey, Herb. I'm just trying to figure out what I want my Gopher to do.
I know what you get them to do.
No, don't be silly. Men have no part in this silly little deal.
All right, okay.
Actually, you know what? Why don't you just go over there and try to make my little Gopher tall?
That one?
Mm-hmm.
All right. I know you can talk, but you're doing a really good job, and I know Bev's hard on you, but... Your hair kind of looks good straight, too. What's your name?
You're wasting your time. She's as good as mute.
I don't know. Maybe she kind of keeps an attractive silence. Well, see you around.
Bye. Stop smiling. You were talking to him. Well, don't look at him, don't talk to him, and don't smile at him. Okay, Gopher. The bus comes in 15 minutes. You're gonna go in and ask people what they ate for breakfast. And you're not gonna tell them that you're being initiated.
When did you eat for breakfast?
Live on mythological moors, and they fly in the sun all day, singing sweet and wild. They're vibrant purple, and their eyebrows are especially tasty.
Oh,
and are you mythological too?
No, but I hope to be one day. I heard it's fantastic for one's ego.
Oh, well, thank you very much. Have a nice day.
In the darkness, the words of the old man came to me. The image of heather birds singing sweet and wild flew through my mind. The girls of the sorority had once seemed like peacocks to me, beautiful and enchanting, but suddenly I realized what they really were, common sparrows, pale gray-brown birds in a flock, one like the other, all exactly alike. And then I thought of Tracy, with her strange socks and colored hair. And I thought of myself. We weren't sparrows, we were heatherbirds, wings flashing quick and purple in the bright light. At times, we would experience loneliness, but mostly we were strong and proud in our freedom.
And it was all yellow. So then I took my turn. What a thing to have done. It was all yellow.
Within Millicent, another melody soared.
Your skin